Ladies and gentlemen, Second Thoughts on the beat.
And you know,
big up to Lace Cadence. Been looking out for this one, man. I love hip-hop music. I just hate the ego. The politics that follow it, getting caught in it can be lethal. See, I love the community, cause the community will embrace you. But when you turn your back, the community is the people that will hate you. See, everybody's striving for that same shit, to get paid and make it. And I'ma be honest, I'm trying to become famous. So when someone makes a move, watch that person next to you, cause I warn ya, I love Hova, but jealousy's the takeover. Here come the meme of, I can't do what he does. And where does that lead us? To the ego that feeds us. I wish that I could just do what I do, but when the door opens for him, I'm afraid there won't be enough room. Comparison's a motherfucker. Like MLK said, we all want that bandleader syndrome, and it won't stop. This concept makes me wonder, is it the commodity of the music or the ego that is killing hip-hop? It's the ego that makes me not get respect and death.
I said it's the ego
that makes me talk shit behind people's
back. You know that it's the ego
that's constantly polluting my consciousness, so ingrained in my brain that I can barely even acknowledge.
It's the ego
that makes the present moment jet lag.
I said it's the ego
that has me tripping about the next
you
man.
You know that it's the ego
that makes me not go to the front of the show, cause the performers have exactly what I want.
I'm so cool,
for real.
No, dude, I'm sick with it, spit it different. And if you just flow too, I listen looking for glitches and rip them to show and prove that my rhythm's a little bit more intricate, just to boost my ego. It's so ego, threatened by so many different kinds of people. It seems that if you're going through something and life is feeling uncomfortable, the immediate place you go is to your ego to comfort you. When Boom Bap got signed, I hated on him. When Grayskull got signed, I hated Henry. And that's hard to admit, but since I'm really being honest, I wanted to be one of the first to make it as a Northwest rap artist. Instead of taking it as a plus for my region, I took it as a cut to my dreams of making it out of this political scene of Northwest haters to be next. I guess I'm just like them, jealous of who's taking that step. It's the ego that makes me not give respect and death.
I said it's the ego
that makes me talk shit behind people's
you
back.
You know that it's the ego
that's constantly polluting my consciousness, so ingrained in my brain that I can barely even acknowledge.
It's the ego
that makes the present moment jet lag.
I said it's the ego
that has me tripping about the next
you
man.
You know that it's the ego
that makes me not go to the front of the show, cause the performers have exactly what I want.
Now everybody got one, but people trying to front, claiming that they're on the humble but cocky. Now it comes up when we judge or feel threatened by someone, but everyone still be like, man, that's not me. And let me break it down, son, it's only a lack of love for ourselves, cause we're submerged and I gotta be the best and number one, but it's just that we don't trust in our heart, and that's what stops me. It's the ego.